Hi students, how are you? Are you fine now? Today I came here to discuss the general science second chapter, components of food. In previous class we have discussed what are the food items, what are the ingredients needed to prepare a food, plant products, animal products, and the classification of animals on the basis of their food habits. All these are studied in previous class. Now we will discuss what are the components of a food. What is components of a food? We know that all the food items contain some ingredients that are needed to prepare a food. Some ingredients needed to prepare a food. These ingredients contain some components that are needed our body. These components are known as nutrients. All the food items needed some ingredients to prepare. These ingredients contain some components that are needed our body. These components are known as nutrients. The major nutrients are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, minerals, and vitamins. In addition to these, some dietary fibers and water are included in food that also needed our body. Then we can test the presence of carbohydrates, fats and proteins in food with a simple method. With simple methods, we can test the presence of carbohydrates, fats and proteins. In this method, we needed three solutions, that are iodine solution, copper sulfate solution and solution of caustic soda. These solutions are needed to test the presence of carbohydrates, fats and proteins. First, we can test the presence of carbohydrates in food. First, we can test the presence of carbohydrates in food. There are many types of carbohydrates. The main carbohydrates found in food are starch and sugar. The main carbohydrates found in food are starch and sugar. To test presence of starch, we need iodine solution. Do you know how to make iodine solution? We can make iodine solution by adding 2 or 3 drops of iodine in a test tube half filled with water. It's an iodine solution. And then take some food or raw ingredients. Pour 2 or 3 drops of iodine solution into it. Then its color change into a blue-black color. We can know that this food contain starch. We can know that this food contain starch when its color change into blue-black. This is the test of carbohydrates in food. Then we can test the presence of proteins in food. How to test the presence of proteins in food? It's need solution of caustic soda and copper sulfate solution. How to make copper sulfate solution? We can take 2 grams of copper sulfate and adding 100 milliliter water. This is copper sulfate solution. We can make copper sulfate solution by adding 2 grams of copper sulfate in 100 milliliter water. We can make the solution of caustic soda by dissolving 10 grams of caustic soda in 100 milliliter of water. This is the solution of caustic soda. Then we can test the presence of protein. Take some food. If you take the solid food, you first need make paste of it or powder of it. Then take this paste or powder in a test tube, add 10 drops of water into it and shake well. Then add 2 drops of solution of copper sulfate and 10 drops of solution of caustic soda and shake well. And let it stand for a few minutes. After few minutes, we can see if we can see this candle change into a violet color, it shows the food item contain protein. If the candle in the test tube change into a violet color, it shows the food item contain protein. Then we can test the presence of fat in food. Take some food, wrap it in a paper and crush it. After straighten the paper, we observe it carefully. Then we can see some oily patch on it. It shows this food item contain fat. First, take some food, wrap it in a paper and crush it. After straighten the paper, if we can see some oily patch on it, it shows the food item contain fudge. So, in this class, we have discussed the components of food and how to test the presence of carbohydrates, proteins and fat in food. So, let's wind up our class. We will meet in next class. Okay, thank you.